In the previous class, we started with chapter 6, The Millionaire Miser, page number 46. We started with this new chapter, term 2 portion, chapter 6, The Millionaire Miser. What did we learn in this lesson, or what did we know so far? Who are the characters in this lesson? The characters are Sushil, his wife, and a person called Sakha. And there were many other people from the kingdom, people around. So the main character in this lesson or in the story is Sushil and his wife. Now, who was Sushil? Sushil was a common man. He was a common man, but he was a very big miser. He was a very big miser. What he did? He only collected money. He never thought of spending it. He wanted to eat, but he did not
want
to
spend. Page number?
Page number 46. Chapter 6, The Millionaire Miser. Miser means a stingy person. A person who only wants to save and collect, who does not want to spend money. Sushil was a miser. Miser in the sense, a person who does not like to spend money. Sushil was a miser. Though his treasure house was full, he was too stingy to give away even the smallest coin. Since food cost money, he ate almost nothing and starved his family and servants as well. He was so stingy, children. He was so miser. At times, he never even ate food, nor did he give his family food, and even his servants many times went without eating food. Why do we work? We work so that we earn, we get money, and we can provide all the facility to our family people. Parents work so that they earn money and they can fulfill the basic needs of children. Their wants, whatever good food item they want to eat, good clothing, outing, anything, purchasing things, celebrations, we need money for all such things. So parents or elders in the family go out and work so that they make money, so that they fulfill the children's or the family members' demand. But Sushil was a different person. He was hardworking. He had lot of money with him. But what is the use? He never spent even a single coin. Not for food, not for anything. He deprived his family, his children, his servant from giving them what they want. One morning, as Sushil took his daily walk through the town, he saw a young boy eating a sweet rice dumpling. Sushil's mouth watered as he made his way home. So one day, early morning, as he was taking a morning walk, he saw a boy eating a dumpling, that is, a sweet rice dumpling, a sort of a pancake or a cupcake which is made out of rice. And the minute Sushil saw the boy eating the rice dumpling, his mouth started watering. If only I could ask my wife to make me a sweet dumpling, he said to himself. But if I want one, so would so would my wife. If my wife wanted one, so would the children. And if the children wanted one, so would the servant. So I had better just keep quiet. So he thought, if I go home and ask my wife to prepare a sweet rice, sweet dumplings for me, my wife also will feel like eating one. So if my wife, if I want to eat, then my wife also has to make one for her, because even she wants to eat. And if my wife wants to eat, my children also wants to eat. And if my children want to eat, my servants also will like to eat. So again, I have to spend so much of money to buy all these things to make these dumplings. So it is better that I don't eat. I don't want a dumpling, because if I have to eat one dumpling, I have to make so many dumplings for my wife, my children, my servants. So I better not ask, I better not eat. Because he was a very stingy person, he was a very miser. When Sohail arrived home, he said nothing but the dumpling. When Sohail arrived home, he said nothing about the dumpling. But he wanted one so badly, he felt weak. His wife Nirmala came to him and asked, "What is wrong, dear husband?" So she lay groaning and he clenched his teeth. He didn't want to tell his wife what he wanted. Why was he sad? Why was he sad? But his wife understood there is something wrong with his husband that he is not sharing. So she kept on asking him what was the reason why he is so annoyed or upset. So she lay groaning and he clenched his teeth. When his wife questioned him, so she became more angry, because first of all he was frustrated because he saw the boy eating the dumpling and his mouth was watering. And he wanted to eat one, he thought he will ask his wife to make one. But he dropped the idea, he dropped the plan. He decided he will not tell anything, because if he has to eat, then his wife also will eat, his children also will eat, and his servant also will eat. So he has to spend more money. So he was very angry. So he was biting his teeth in anger. "Is there something you want?" asked Nirmala. Sushil's face grew red, then purple. At last, he squeaked, "I would like a sweet rice dumpling." And finally, Sushil couldn't control. He told his wife that he wanted a sweet rice dumpling. "That is no problem," said Nirmala. "We are wealthy enough. I will make sweet dumplings for the whole town." Sushil gasped in horror. The minute Sushil told his wife that he wanted a rice dumpling, his wife said, "It is not a big issue. There is no problem. We are so rich, we are so wealthy. I can make dumplings for the entire town. I can make dumplings for the entire town." The minute Sushil heard that his wife is saying that there's no problem, she can make the dumplings for the entire town, Sushil became angry. He became angry because he has to spend more money now. He was only thinking his wife, his children and servant. But his wife said she is ready to make dumplings for the entire town. Now there's a big question mark on Sushil, because he has to spend more money. "You will make a pauper of me." He got very angry with his wife and he said, "You are going to make me poor. You are going to waste all my money by making the dumplings for the entire town." "Well then," said Nirmala, I'll make dumplings for our family and servant. So Nirmala says, okay, fine then. I will not make dumplings for the town. I will make dumplings only for our entire family and the servants. That is, her husband, she, her children and her servants. Well then, said Nirmala, I'll make dumplings for our family and the servants. Why would the servants need any, said Sushi. He said, why do we have to give it to the servants? It is for us. We have to prepare any. Why should we give it to the servants? Why would the servants need any, said Sushi. Then I'll make them for us and the children. So the wife agreed even for this and she said, fine. I will not make for the servants, but I will make only for our family, that is you, me and children. I am sure the children can do without. So he had problem even for that. He said, I am sure the children can do without. I don't think so children will like the dumplings. There's no need to prepare for the children. Then I'll make one for you and one for me. Why should you want one? Said Sushil shyly. He's so stingy. He's not allowing his own wife and children to eat. He says, why do you want dumpling? You make only one dumpling. Why would you want one? Said Sushil shyly. Nirmala sighed. She went out and returned after a while with a single sweet dumpling. Then she looked on as she devoured every crumb. So Nirmala went to the kitchen and came back after some time and she prepared only one dumpling and brought and gave to Sushi. And she sat observing her husband. And the way he was eating the sweet dumpling, he didn't even spare a small piece of crumb also in the plate. That means he really wanted to eat, but he didn't want to spend money. Nirmala sighed. She went out and returned after a while with a single sweet dumpling. Then she looked on as Sushil devoured every crumb. Sakha, king of heaven, who was sitting on his marble stone in his 1,000-mile-high palace, happened to see all this. Children, we always say that when you do wrong, when you do evil, when you steal, when you speak lies, when you hurt somebody, when you push somebody, when you beat somebody, you think nobody is watching you. Nobody is watching you. But it is wrong, children. God is always watching us. Our every activity, our every moment, our good deeds and our bad deeds, everything, whatever we do, God is watching us. When we speak lies, when we steal, when we cheat, when we hurt others' feelings, when we beat, when we tell wrong things about others, and we think that nobody is watching us, nobody is seeing us. But children, I tell you, God is everywhere. God is everywhere. He's watching not only you, he's watching me, he's watching our parents, he's watching everyone, he's watching the entire world. He knows everything what we are doing. So we cannot hide anything from God. So God was watching Sushil and his behavior and he decided to come down and teach Sushil a lesson. He wanted to teach Sushil a lesson. So what he did, we will see. Sakha, king of heaven, who was sitting on his marble throne in his 1,000-mile-high palace, happened to see all this. Not in 77 millennia, he declared, have I ever seen such a miser? I will teach this fellow a lesson. So Sakha, the god of heaven, decided to teach a lesson to Sushil. So the god waited till the next day. When Sushil left for his morning walk, he made himself look just like Sushil and came down to earth. Sakha walked into Sushil's house as if he were Sushil. So the god Sakha, the god of heaven, he came down to earth and he disguised himself. He changed himself. He transformed himself, same like Sushil, and he went to Sushil's house. In Sushil's own voice, he told a servant, "Run through the town and invite everyone you see. Today, I will share my wealth." So God, Sakha, the God of heaven, he came down to earth, he disguised himself like Sushil and he went to his house. He called one of his servants and he told him to go and do an announcement in the public that I, Sushil, want to share my wealth to the common people. When Nirmala heard these words, she cried, "Husband, can this be true? Heaven can be praised for your change of heart." When Nirmala, Sushil's wife, heard this, she was shocked because there's such a big change in her husband. But in reality, it was not her husband Sushil, it was God. God came to test Sushil. God came to teach a lesson to Sushil because of his behavior. So we stop here because it's time up. The second session teacher will continue in our next lesson. In our next class, we will continue the lesson. For till we meet in the next class, you read this lesson till where I have explained to you, and this is what we learn. If we lie, if we cheat, God is watching us. He will come to punish us. He will come to teach us a lesson. So we should fear our parents, we should fear God. We should not think that we are too great. We are, too great and we can do anything. No one will punish us. It is wrong. God is always watching us.
Thank you, ma'am. Thank you.